So when you're growing with natural amendments, the thing about it is if you end up using a smaller size pot, like a 3 gallon or a 5 gallon, there's not going to be, and I could be wrong on this, but there's not going to be enough amendment. Normally, a lot of people probably, just because when they're just getting started, they don't know how much to amend. They don't know, they're like, well, is it too much? Am I going to burn my plants? And they're
exactly.
Right.
Exactly.
And lack of awareness around the what you're putting in. If it is a real natural amendment, like a bone meal, blood meal, or some type of thing like that, it's not going to be bioavailable to the plant for a couple weeks. So that's why they say cooking right. Your soil, right? You put it in there. It kind of helps break down a little bit. You get your microbiology going a little bit. Then you transplant in a week or two later, and it's a little bit more available. If you transplant immediately in, the plant might show up as some nutrient deficiencies initially, but then it'll grow out of it because more of the organics in that soil, it becomes more bioavailable.
Right.
So when we switched over to using synthetic fertilizers and you're force feeding the nutrients, there's no need, right, to have a large pot, you know, because you're force feeding your nutrients. And so you can get away with a 1 gallon, you know, you see all the size things people are growing nowadays. It's like
the miracles they do.
Exactly, right? They have these 4x4 cubes or 6x6 cubes, and they're growing big old plants, tiny little root systems. You know, or people are force feeding 2 gallon size pots, finishing them off. And that's in large part because, like we said, they're force feeding the nutrients, and there's no need to have extra bioavailability because you can't really use organic in drip irrigation. It's going to clog. It's going to do all these other issues. So you really are kind of set up to really just use water, right? Even if you use humic acid or these other thicker stuff, it'll clog your stuff over time, the drip and all that stuff. So when growing with bone meal, blood meal, all these other things, you normally might end up having to grow with a larger pot, you know, like a 7 or a 10 gallon size pot, and amend the soils with more than what you would actually think you would need, because it will become available as the grow is going. And then you can run into deficiencies 3 weeks into flowering, 4 weeks into flowering. And this is for indoor growing, right? If you're done outdoor growing, you might be growing in a 30-gallon size pot, and you're going to have enough amendments in that soil, most likely, to get you pretty good way through. And then you can use like a tea with additional potassium or additional flowering things in that tea, and you force feed it. And that's how growers will do it, right? They will like amend their soil for the veg, and for 3 or 4 weeks into the flower. Of course, they'll use teas, but then they'll use teas to kind of like boost up certain things that they see are becoming issues or might be issues, or they'll need extra later down the road. So that's why you probably are also seeing a deficiency of some level right now. And it would make sense, a magnesium and a potassium, a phosphorus, thank you. Phosphorus deficiency is because you're in veg right now. You amended your soils 3 weeks ago, a month ago maybe, and you're using a 4-3-3, so that probably itself is not very hot. And I'm not saying hot like a 15-14-14. I'm talking like hot like when you mix it into your soil, you probably could have put more in there than what you initially put. You know what I mean?
Gotcha, 100%.
And that it's okay, right? This is the fascinating part about gardening. You're like, oh, okay, I'm seeing how I'm going to have to do this if I want to grow without all the chemis, right? Is
good. Exactly.
A little bit larger pot, you might only be able to fit 5 plants in your 4x4 tent or your growing space versus see a green and you're trying to put 12 or 15 in there, right? And you're trying to max out square footage based upon a growing technique and stuffing the room versus the organic method. You're more in the long-term gain higher quality than the...
Exactly.
And, but once you start like mending your soils and hone-tuning it in, like one of my other growers, he just yielded 191 grams. He averages around 180 to 191 off of his plants, and he veges, I think, maybe 3 weeks.
Seed or clone?
Seed. He goes to seed, maybe veges 3 weeks after poppy, maybe 3.5. I have to double check our numbers and our schedules. Because he's a client. Like, we're home tuning each other's, you know, thing type situation. But and
are you offering service? So you kind of do consultation also?
Yeah, I do consultation. A lot of people don't do it, but the guys that are more like growing, you know, greenhouse, or they're growing for specific, like they're trying to win a cannabis cup, or they're trying to, and I charge $50 a month, you know, and then cancel any time.
Oh.
Yeah, it's cheap. I'm not trying to screw people or any of it. I love the growing, and I love being, you know, connected, and I try to make it inexpensive. But
not to cut you off again, but, you know, I always have questions, and I'm always hesitant to reach out to anyone because, you know, no fault of anyone's, but a lot of people just don't have the time to deal with somebody asking them, is this a phosphorus deficiency? You know what I mean? So it's great to reach out to somebody that can say, like, oh, no, I actually love doing this. Because that's what I'm from. It's the love of it. I think I'm more in love with growing the plant than, you know, the other part of it. If you get my, you know what I mean?
Absolutely. You know, I shot this video a couple of months ago, which was, it's actually like my lowest ranked video, but I told everyone, like, if you want to be at the best at this, you have to create your own religion. You know, you have to create a religion, a practice around this. And in that video, I talk about the mindset. The mindset is nine-tenths of the game. You know, it's like you wake up and you're not really enjoying what you're doing, you're not going to get a great outcome. But if you love
it, you're going to have that.
Exactly.
You're going to have that.
Exactly. Yeah, so that's what you're going through. I would say magnesium, secondary phosphorus. Reason why is magnesium and phosphorus are very important in the whole ATP photosynthesis game. You know, so it would make sense if the magnesium is starting to get a little lack that you're going to see some secondary phosphorus just because they both play with each other. They both work together.
Gotcha.
And actually, just to go a little more geekier on you on this, is the chlorophyll molecule, it's all bounded around one magnesium molecule. So every chlorophyll molecule, you have like 70 hydrogen, 55 carbon, then you have like 5 oxygen, 4 nitrogens or something like that, and then one magnesium molecule. And all these other gas molecules, in a sense, become like a substance all bounded around one magnesium molecule.
Wow.
Yeah, that's huge. Yeah, I'm like, whoa. So
yeah.
And that's chlorophyll, right? And chlorophyll does photosynthesis. And so, and phosphorus is huge in the photosynthesis part, but it's also developing root systems. And if you're having a magnesium issue and photosynthesis is starting to like reduce down, then it makes sense that you're going to have a secondary problem, right? And that what's that next mineral that's going to be affected in that whole photosynthesis process?
Gotcha. It makes sense.
Yeah. Cool. Yeah, hit me up if you need anything else, man.
Do you have, like, how would I sign up for the...
Okay, yeah, I'll send you a link.
Yeah, do that.
Okay, brother. Yeah, and...
I appreciate it.
And we'll go from there. I appreciate you, man.
Yeah, we'll definitely go from there. And this conversation alone was, you know, I'm really grateful.
Thank you.
I kind of, like, know, but it's just, like I never had anybody to hold my hand, right? I just learned and got burned along the way trying shit, right? So, but it's always good to have somebody to kind of like reassure you and say like, no, yeah, it kind of is what you think it is.
I 100% agree with you, man. And just to throw out one more thing for you is I've never had a client longer than 2 cycles. And I actually brag about that. I will get
that's a great thing.
Yeah, like, I'll get you to a point where I tell you, bro, I don't think you need to pay for this anymore unless you want to take it into the business world of stuff, like developing corporations and all that other stuff, and then it can keep going.
That's exactly where I want to go to. Like, this is something, like, New York, you know, I'm in New York. New York became legal, so I kind of want to get into the clone side of it because I think that's, like, maybe the cheapest way to get my foot into the door. But just to elaborate on what you just said, I absolutely do want to get into the business.
All right, well, let's do it in the groin and out.
Yeah, and let's creep before we walk.
And we'll do the business too at the same time. The first question I have when we connect on the thing for all people I connect with is, what is your vision? What's your vision? What's your mission, vision, and values? Like, what do you want? Like, 2 years from now, 5 years from now, where do you see yourself in the industry? And then I tailor the consulting around your vision. Where
right.
do you want to end up?
Right, gotcha. Well, you know, we're going to have a lot of discussion because that's me saying the cloning, I'm looking at the cheapest way to get into the door. I can, in terms of like taxes and all this other bullshit, but you know, we'll definitely have to have long conversations surrounding that.
Okay, cool. I look forward to it.
Send me the link.
Yes, sir, brother. I'll send you in the next 23 minutes.
Take your time.
Okay.
Take your time. Thanks, I appreciate it. Thank you.
All right.
I'll be covering magnesium, calcium, phosphorus, nitrogen, molds, providing comparison videos, and like I said, I'll be providing in such great detail that by the end of all of the series of videos, after you finish watching them, when you go into your grow room, you'll actually be able to hear your plants as they speak to you.